This short video clip is intended to show you how to write a short program to conduct a simple dialogue with the user. It's very similar to Hello World that you did previously, but it interacts with the user to gather more information and then greets the user with their name, or rather than just saying Hello World. So let's take a quick look at the program. At the beginning here we have the usual comments that describe what the program does. These are going to be standard in any program that you write. They're all single-line comments in conformance with a current style for C++. Each line begins with a double slash, a double forward slash. We begin with a description of what the program does. I've called this the Hello Name program. I've stored it in a file called hellonamed.cpp. The next line specifies the author of the program. Remember that if you're working with a partner, please put both names there. And remember that both of you have to upload the finished assignment to your assignment folder in WebCT. I'm not able to grade an assignment which you haven't submitted, so both of you need to submit the assignment. Please write the date that you wrote the program. Accredit any sources that you may have used in writing the program. Now, there's no need to accredit the textbook. There's no need to accredit my notes. But if you've got help from another student or you've got help from somewhere out on the internet, please be sure to make a note of where you may have received help from. I have no objection to your getting help. We all need help from time to time. But please, in the interest of academic disclosure, indicate where you went for that help. Now the next two lines down here, the pound include IOStream and the pound include string, are probably going to be standard boilerplate for any program that you might write this term. We've talked about IOStream last time. You need the pound include string if we're going to process strings of text that the user might input from the keyboard. And in this case, as you'll see later, we're going to want the user to enter their last name and their first name, so the text that the user enters we're going to store in so-called string variables. Anytime in C++ you want to use string variables, you need a pound include string, as I've done here. So I think any program you write this term will require that pound include string. As before, any program you write is going to use the namespace std. This is not the only way to use that namespace, by the way, as I've noted in other discussions, but you should plan to use that namespace either using this technique or the technique presented in the book. The next thing is a procedure whose name is main. The procedure begins right here with this open curly brace. It ends right here with the matching close curly brace. The name of the procedure is main with a lowercase m, and that's really important. Main is a very special procedure because it's the first procedure that executes when you start your program. So in general, you can call your procedures anything you want, but the one that you have no control over is the very first one that you want to execute, and that must always be called main, as I've done here. For syntactic reasons, we need a couple of parentheses here, left paren and a right paren. And when the program executes, the standard convention in C++ is that any program, when it terminates, reports back to the operating system with an error code. If the program terminated successfully without error, then the error code value is zero. As you see here, when the program finishes, it returns to the operating system with a return value right there of zero. Zero by convention means that no errors occur. On the other hand, if an error occurs, it's traditional to designate that error with an error code number, some value other than zero, and that'll be the return value from the main function. So the reason we have the word int here is quite simply because this program returns an integer value to the operating system, in this case zero, but as I just indicated, could be, in fact, be anything else. Okay, now the next thing as a matter of style, any variables that we're going to use in our program are declared next. In this case, we're going to be reading a last name from the user, which is a string of text. I've declared it as being of type string, which is declared, strings are declared in the string section of the std namespace. And so lname is a string in which we're going to store the user's last name, and fname is a string in which we're going to store the user's first name. Reply, by the way, is a single char. It's not a string. It's one and only one character. And it's used down here later for when the user just enters the single character Q to quit the program. Okay, this section are known as declarations. I've declared three variables. The variable of type char called reply, the variable of type string called lname, and the variable of type string called fname. There are, of course, certain requirements for what C++ variable names can be. I won't cover those now, but you can read about those in the book. So, the next thing that happens is the program outputs the text hello world to the user. The output text in this case is a literal text. It begins with a double quote and it ends with a double quote. And we write it to the so-called cout object, which is standard output on a Windows system that's going to normally at least be mapped to the screen. So the text hello world is written to the screen. The ENDL here means that a new line character is also written to the screen. So we get hello world and the cursor moves down onto the next line. We ask the user to enter their last name right here. Notice there's no ENDL here. We want the prompt to stay on the same line as the please enter your last name text. The user then reads in, we then read in the user's reply. So you may notice that I use CIN, which is standard input, which by default, of course, is going to be connected to the keyboard. Whatever the user types in at the keyboard is read in. Notice the two arrows there, if you will, the greater than signs point the other way. The input from the keyboard is read into my string variable called lname that we declared up here. Then we do the same thing for first name. So we've read the user's input for last name, we've read the user's input for first name, and now we output the greeting message. So the first thing we output here, we output this string welcome, followed by a space actually. That's a literal string in double quotes. We output that to standard output. Then we output the first name to standard output. Then we output a space right there, literally in double quotes, to standard output. Then we output the last name, whatever string is contained in, the string variable lname to be precise. And then we output the string to CS161 followed by a new line character. As always, note that every line of C++, most lines anyway, end with a semicolon. We'll find some exceptions to that later in the class, but in this case, every line ends with a semicolon. And notice, by the way, that the entire program is indented from the open curly brace to the closed curly brace. Now this last section of code right here, these three lines, are necessary so that when you run the program, the output just doesn't flash on the screen momentarily and then the output window closes so that you can't see the output window. The idea is that we're going to output this string press Q followed by enter to quit. And then the program suspends, it waits until the user enters a reply, like enters the character Q followed by a new line character. So the purpose of these two lines here is simply to pause the program so that its output is visible on the screen until the user has seen it, viewed it, done what he wants with it, and then he enters Q, which gets read into reply, and the program then terminates. So that's it. That should be enough to get you going with your first homework assignment. Good luck. Thank you.